Auxiliaries View by Patricia Hale. Patty Hale's Auxiliaries View is accompanied in this issue by a half-length front view photo of Patty. She is dressed in formal business attire and has a small name badge. To the right of the headline for the column in the print version of the bulletin is the familiar BVAA emblem. The Auxiliaries View begins with the subtitle, Opinion to Education to Advocacy. In my last column, I elaborated on the topic of opinion versus advocacy as it relates to our blinded veterans, their families, and other caregivers. In this column, I will share one option that exists. It is the option of education. To begin, pick up your smartphone and look up two words, doxophobia and allodoxophobia. We live in a very social world. So how do we, as caregivers and the blind, rise above the sea of waves, currents, and life around us so that we become victims of neither of the two phobias? This question has no easy answer given the social climate that has created these phobias. Education. Did you ever hear the adage, learn one, do one, teach one? Now, apply this concept to an aspect of blindness with which you are most familiar or an aspect you would like to know more about. An example would be causes of blindness. Once you have learned more about what you have chosen, apply it to your own situation and compare it with others like yours. It is likely that you will realize at some point that blindness is as individual as DNA. Maybe you will choose to learn more about other kinds of blindness or how others deal with their blindness. Perhaps you will choose to learn how to deal with blindness in the home. Finally, you will find yourself sharing with others and teaching others what you have learned. From experience, another form of education, you learn what works for you. You find and learn tools of accommodation and how to use and apply them to your situation. Then you share what you have learned with others. The same applies to new technology, guide dogs, recreational activities, and so on. In your background, you have skills. Although many of these skills are difficult to transfer to your blindness, accommodations may help. In many cases, your loved ones or you will work by trial and error to transfer what you always used to do into your present situation. BRCs and BROs can help, but only if they know you are interested. Then there is the phrase heard around my house. Honey, I need your eyes for a minute. This usually occurs in a situation that is difficult, even for a sighted person. With education, no one can learn everything they wish to, but everyone can learn something of interest to them, or they can discover a need to know something. Positive interest and feedback frequently create greater interest, even a passion, for what you do. Sharing what you know, and especially what you are passionate about at the appropriate time and place, helps to educate others. Advocacy, should you have the knowledge and desire to do so, is the next step. Advocacy is frequently used to make a strong point, to right a wrong, or to stand up for a cause, such as helping to initiate, support, and even write laws, or to educate the sighted public about the need for particular accommodations, rights, laws, and enforcement. My challenge for each of you, learn, experience, and share. Then, advocate. You will be glad you did.